Hey everybody, Mike Iaconelli back out here in the shop with another little cool modification, little trick that might help you on your next fishing excursion. I want to talk to you today about using color, using some paint to help you get more bites. And gonna show you a really cool little trick that I do that's different than what most guys are doing. You know, I'm a big believer in using dye and paint like Spike It to help modify the lure to look more natural, match the hatch. I'm so big into that. Adding a little chartreuse when you're trying to imitate bluegill or yellow perch. Adding a little orange when you're trying to imitate a crawfish. Blue for a crab, white for shad. You know, I love that. I love dialing a bait in. But I also like to use paint to help make the bait more visible. Clear water, stained water, but especially in dirty water, a lot of times using color to make the bait pop will help the fish find it and help the fish react to the bait better. You know, chartreuse, orange, those colors dipped on the tail of a bait have been a staple for so many years. And about 5 years ago, I started playing with reverse dyeing a bait. And I want to talk to you today about this technique. My favorite paint to use for this one is the Spike It. This is the Worm and Chunk paint. The great thing about this paint, and I'm going to show you in a second when I paint one of these up, is that instead of dipping it, you actually get a little brush. You could be a little more exact with it. The other great thing about this paint versus the traditional dye is that this paint is latex based. And what that means is it's gonna stay on longer and it's gonna pop. It's gonna be a brighter color. So I'm a big fan of the Worm and Chunk paint. But I wanna show you this process of reverse dyeing a bait. I grabbed just one of my all-time favorite, most versatile lures out there. This is a green pumpkin, 4.25 inch Berkeley Powerbait General. You could do more stuff with this bait than you can imagine. Start with the Texas rig. Texas rig's a good one. Here I've got a little 3/0 VMC flipping hook. I've got a VMC 3/8 ounce tungsten weight, it's pegged, and I'm gonna do my normal Texas rig on that bait. Just around the hook, make sure that thing's nice and straight. A Texas rig soft stick bait can be phenomenal when other soft plastics aren't working. And you know, the funny thing about it is if you look at most people, when they dye this bait, right? When they get this bait, they get this soft stick bait and they go to dye it, they're gonna stick the tail of the bait into the dye. And when they fish that bait, the bright spot is the tail, right? Is up here. I want you to look at where the target becomes. If it's Texas rigged and the chartreuse is on the tail, the target, the bright spot, the thing that's attracting that fish or getting his attention, where he's going to attack, look how far it is away from the hook. But if we get our little Spike It Worm and Chunk paint, and instead of dipping the tail, I'm going to color the head of this bait. Look how easy this is to apply. And I want you to see how bright this is. Look how that chartreuse, that bright chartreuse is really maintaining its color. And I like to paint about, half of an inch, sometimes a little less, sometimes maybe a quarter of an inch of the head of that bait. And I'm just gonna paint it up, okay? So I've painted the head of the bait. This stuff dries really quick. So a lot of times what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna dye a whole bunch up. Here's another one. This is a Texas Rig Weightless Senko, a little soft stick bait style lure. And I'm gonna do the same thing. I'm gonna get my dye, and instead of the head of the bait, the tail of the bait, look at this. I'm dyeing the head of the bait. A lot of you guys watching might remember the Mark Zona, the Z show that I shot with him a few years back, where we were catching a lot of spawning and post-spawn fish, and we were painting the head of the bait. Now look what happens. Now, when that bait's fallen, hits the bottom, it's laying on the bottom, it's on the fall, that fish is attracted to the bright spot, the reaction point. It's at the head of the bait, which is right where the hook's at. So a lot of those missed strikes, a lot of those little bites you got before that you missed, now they're going to be attracted to the head of the bait, the bright spot. Really cool little modification. You do the same thing with a shaky head. Here's a little VMC rugby head. I'm going to do my normal little Texas rig. And there it goes. At the head of the bait and not the tail. Really cool modification. I want to show you one more way that I'm going to use color to help me in my fishing. Once again, it's the same paint. This is the Spike It Worm and Chunk paint. And instead of using the paint to add color to a swim bait to make it look more natural, I'm going to add color to this bait to make it more visible. I've used this same thing on topwaters, on frogs, on techniques where you want to see what your bait is doing. Use the paint to make it so you can see the bait. Swim baits, frogs, topwaters, this is perfect. Here we've got the fire red, and this is all I do. I want to show you how easy this is to add to a topwater or a frog or a swim bait. All I do is I get it, and this happens to be a, by the way, this is a Storm Arashi swim bait. Brandon Polinick helped design. It's a glide bait, it's awesome. But I want to be able to watch it. And all I do is I get that, I'll use red. A lot of times I'll use orange or pink or the chartreuse. And I'm going to add a little bright spot to the head of this bait. Same thing. I'm not going to go crazy. That might be about an inch and a quarter, an inch, maybe an inch and a half sometime. And again, this is fast drying. I'm going to let it set up and dry. And now when I'm fishing a lure that I have to watch, that I have to see with my eyes, this is going to help me keep constant visual contact of that bait. Swim bait, frog, topwater. Now I can see it. As that lure starts coming through the water, I want to know what that lure is doing. And when I'm watching a bass follow it, and it's following it, and I see that bass turn, and I see that red spot disappear, or that pink spot or that chartreuse spot, I know that fish ate the bait. Same with the frog, same with the topwater. Adding a little color to make the bait more visible so you can see it with your own eyes. This is all stuff you can do real easy on the boat, in the shop. Great thing about these things, they store real easily in your backpack, in your boat, wherever you're at. Think about a couple of these tips. Using color to make the bait more visible. Using color on the opposite end of your bait from what everybody else is doing. Think about a few of those tips. I guarantee you're going to get a few more bites and you're going to be a better fisherman when you can see your bait. Mike Iaconelli talking about adding color out here in the shop.